Hey guys, Irene here. Today I'm editing an image from my last behind the scenes video. If you missed it, I will put the link in the description down below so you guys can check it out, or it's going to be floating somewhere on the screen. And if you have seen the video, you would know that I had a lot of problems with some lens flares and light leaks. As you can see at the bottom here, we have a huge lens flare happening. And I usually don't have this problem. I normally shoot pretty late in the day where the sun is low and no lens flares are really happening. But this time I scheduled the shoot a little bit too early, my mistake. And I really wanted to shoot in this specific spot because I wanted to get the apple tree in the picture. This was kind of the whole concept for the shoot. So yeah, pretty much I just have to deal with these in post right now. And there is actually a very, very simple way on how to get rid of the lens flare. So I'm gonna go ahead and open this image in Camera Raw. I would also always recommend shooting in Raw. If I shot this in JPEG, this would be a lot harder to get rid of. But because I shot in Raw, I can easily manipulate the exposure of the image. So we're gonna go into Effects right here, and we're gonna use Dehaze. So if I'm gonna slide this up here, as you can see, it really, really corrected the lens flare and it looks so much more uniform now. I'm just gonna go ahead and bring up the shadows a little bit more, so then this corner right here is more similar to this corner right here. I'm gonna make the image also just a little bit warmer. We can go ahead and put more clarity to it, maybe bring up the shadows even a little bit more, and then you can also bring the highlights down here. So I'm gonna go ahead and open the image now. So in this case, the lens flare is not as intense and I actually kind of like it. It gives it a very romantic look, but if you would like to get rid of it, you can do it by pretty much using the dehaze tool again. So I'm gonna go ahead and duplicate my layer by right clicking on the background and choosing duplicate layer. And then I will go into filter and I'm gonna choose Camera Raw filter. Now if you are not on Photoshop CC, you will not have this option here and you will have to manually open the Camera Raw again. But for those of you who do have Photoshop CC, which I definitely recommend you guys get the newest version, you can just press right here and it's just going to take you to our Camera Raw editor once again. I'm just going to dehaze this even more and I'm just going to press OK. Now we're just going to go ahead and create a mask and invert the layer. And now we can pick up our brush and just kind of brush on that second dehaze on top of this image. Just like that. And as you can see, it pretty much took out our lens flare completely. It's just giving me a little bit of a weird yellow color here, so I'm gonna take my eraser tool and just erase it right here. Alright, so this is pretty much it. This is how I very, very easily took out the lens flare in my image. So let's go ahead and check out the before and after. So here's our before. And as you can see, we were able to pretty much take this lens flare completely, which I'm very pleased about because I didn't really want to scrap these pictures as I really, really loved them. So usually I don't edit in Lightroom, but I wanted to include this for all of you Lightroom users out there. This is pretty much the same thing and you can find the dehaze tool in Lightroom as well. Just want to scroll all the way down to effects and there's your dehaze filter. So you can just go ahead and apply that and then just play around with some colors, maybe take out the blue that it creates. Here's an image that I just edited in Lightroom and here you can see the before and after just using dehaze. So I hope you guys enjoyed this really short tutorial. Let me know if you would like to see more of those. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!